Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of Consumer Lab, and I'm going to be talking to you about green tea and giving you some tips on how to use green tea, how to choose green tea, and how to avoid problems with green tea. At Consumer Lab, we've been testing green tea along with all kinds of other health supplements and health foods since 1999. These are some of the more recently tested green tea products that we have tested. They range from pills to bottled green tea to brewed green tea, K-cups for green tea, and matcha green tea, which are come as a powder. There are some big differences among these products that I'll talk about. The reason why people are interested in green tea is that it has health benefits. And these come from the polyphenols, specifically the catechins, and more specifically, a catechin known as EGCG, which is a compound. And we've tested for EGCG and for the levels in all of these products. Another thing we've tested them all for is the amount of heavy metals that occur in them, particularly lead, because lead can occur in green tea leaves. The leaves are kind of like a sponge for lead. They've actually been used for that purpose, for cleaning up lead. So we want to make sure that these products are clean. I'll also be talking about some of the risks in a minute. So in general, the things that green tea can do for you are basically lowering LDL cholesterol or bad cholesterol, lowering the risk of cardiovascular disease, lowering the risk of certain cancers and type 2 diabetes. It's even helped reduce the growth of uterine fibroids in some studies. So there's a variety of things that green tea can do. It's been tested for weight loss and memory enhancement as well. The results are more mixed for those uses, and probably the weight loss benefit relates more to the caffeine in green tea, caffeine which you can get from a number of sources other than green tea. When we test these products for green tea, we find that there's about a cup of green tea has anywhere from about 25 to 75 milligrams of EGCG. So that's a pretty big difference. So if you can choose the right green tea, and these are just the green tea that come in bags that you can get widely, you can really get up to three times as much EGCG from a green tea product. And that information, again, is in our reports, but just be aware that there is a significant difference among the bag green teas. Among the matcha green teas, and matcha is a powder such as this, or this green tea matcha powder. You mix this with warm, slightly hot water. It makes a very nice kind of like soupy tea, which you can drink. There, you're not just getting the liquid, but you're also getting the tea leaves themselves. That seems to be why we're finding higher levels of EGCG in the matcha than in just the brewed green tea, where the levels start at about 75 milligrams of EGCG per cup, which is made from about a teaspoon of matcha powder, to up to about 120 milligrams of EGCG. So you get a bit more EGCG with a cup of matcha than from a cup of brewed tea. Although obviously, if you just want to drink the brewed tea, you can just drink more of it. The cost can vary significantly in terms of how much it costs to get this EGCG from products. We've seen you can get it for as little as 5 cents for 200 milligrams of EGC to as much as over a couple of dollars for the same amount of EGCG. So you can certainly save money by choosing the right product. Some of the concerns that you should have when using green tea are, first of all, if you're using a supplement, basically an EGCG kind of green tea extract, that's where people have run into problems in the past. There has been liver toxicity reported multiple times with the supplements. Typically, when you're taking a high dose containing several hundred milligrams of EGCG, and typically when that's taken without food. They haven't seen problems as much when people are taking these with food or taking a lower dose. So keep that in mind. Other risks with green tea are that it also contains a vitamin K, although that's not necessarily a problem. if you're on a blood thinner, that can affect the dosage of blood thinner that you need to use. You actually only get the vitamin K in significant amounts if you're drinking the matcha green tea, where you actually consume the leaves. You don't really get it from the brewed tea. Pregnant women should not be drinking excessive amounts of green tea, as it can affect their newborn children. Certainly just a couple of cups of green tea per day is not so much a concern. Other issues with green tea are, there's actually been an increased risk of gastric cancer when drinking very hot green tea, really probably just due to the thermal effects of the green tea. Some people have kind of overboard, as always happens with all kinds of health foods and supplements, drinking massive amounts of green tea, pretty much substituting water for green tea or making iced green tea and drinking it all day long. Some of these people have suffered from very brittle bones and teeth because they're getting too much fluoride from the green tea, because green tea does have some fluoride, and that's fine unless you're doing it in excess. So if you wanted to learn more about green tea, please look at our report online on ConsumerLab.com. You do need to be a member, but it gives you access to all of our reports on everything from green tea to every type of major vitamin supplement and herbal supplement, things like CBD and fish oil, etc. And if you have any questions, feel free to post them where you see this video, and we'll try to answer that for you. So again, this is Dr. Todd Cooperman of ConsumerLab.com. Thank you.